So the agenda for today's discussion is, we'll have a brief introduction to Z-Omega and Jiva, where we'll talk about who we are, what we do, who are our customers, and what is Jiva. With all of this, we'll get a brief insight into why the data aggregation and the data exchange is critical for our product. And we'll also talk about the challenges, what we faced and overcome during the course of Jiva's implementation with respect to data integration. Then we'll talk about the rationale behind choosing WSO2 products to build a population health management platform. And we'll look at our new API, which is developed using WSO2 products. And we'll also talk about our next generation SOA model. And towards the end of session, we'll talk about our future development plans. And I would request you all to keep your question towards the end of session, where we will address as many as within the allotted time. Okay, Z-Omega. We are the market leader in a population health management platform, which is founded in 2001. And we have more than 400 employees, headquartered in Plano, Texas, USA, and with other offices in Seattle, as well as Bangalore, India. So Z-Omega mainly focus on the customers which are into healthcare space, which are centered for providing a patient-centric and a population health management platform, such as health plans and third-party administrators. Generally, they are insurance companies and care and disease management organizations and other organizations like provider organizations. They are nothing but physicians and various organizations which are providing healthcare in the healthcare market. So for Z-Omega, has successfully served more than 25 clients, and we are collectively serving more than 30 million individuals across US. And we are also looking forward to expand our business into Europe, Asia, and South American market. So before getting into Jiva, so I just talked about the population health management. So I would like to take a few moments to give a general idea, like what is population health management all about. Population health management is collecting various patients' data from a different hospitals and a various healthcare organizations, and aggregating the data and analyzing the data into a single record where care providers like physicians, insurance companies, and administrators can take a decision to provide a better healthcare by reducing the cost of a healthcare and improving the clinical outcomes of a healthcare market. As you can see, Jiva is the only platform which gives the interoperability, analytics, and a workflow solution for a robust and a scalable and a highly configurable solution in the population health management platform. So as you can see in the image, Jiva enables a collaboration with the various stakeholders like physicians, administrators, care providers, and care teams, pharmacists, in the care continuum to provide a holistic and patient-centric care management. As a product, Jiva has several capabilities such as plug-and-play workflow solutions and robust rule engines that drives the automation of a workflow. And it has one more feature that is called population health analytics to give us the, who needs what kind of information, who has to do a follow-up with the doctor. So those kind of analytic picture will give to the system users. When it comes to integration, Jiva integrates with the various systems, like claim systems, which are responsible for processing the claims, and various EMR and EHR systems. They are responsible for providing the patient's electronic medical record as well as the health information. And it also has the capabilities to integrate with various master data management systems, which are responsible for integrating code values, like international code values, disease codes, and lab test codes into a Jiva, and many more various systems, and also various external data warehouses. So when it comes to data integration challenges, So during our initial days of integration, we built a ETL tool, which is meant for extracting and transforming and loading the data into Jiva. So instead of going for a commercial tool, we built our own ETL framework with a Python as a programming language, with our own business rules, business validations, and a business logic. With this system, we are able to achieve integrating data in the form of flat files, which generally it can be of a CSV and XML, and also using the same system, we used to export the data into the various external systems. So as over the period, as we started getting the bigger clients, the challenge what we had is integrating a data in terms of millions of records in an allotted time, like loading 2 million of records in 3 hours or 10 million of records in 5 hours of a time. So with our framework, we enhanced our framework in such a way where we were able to load the millions of our records into system in an expected manner. As the business requirement changes, where the clients were looking for near real-time or a real-time data integration. So the framework what we built was really strictly meant for the ETL integration. So we built one more system to address the RESTful web services integration with JSON as a payload. And we used a pyramid framework to build our RESTful web services. So with these two services and systems, we were able to achieve data integration with a flat file as well as the RESTful web services. But as you can see, so there are clients who are more open to SOAP and SOAP-based web services integration. And because of limitations, these systems are specific to individual needs, ETL for only ETL, RESTful for only for the RESTful web services. So we built one more system, so that is specific to address the SOAP-based web services integration. So with the Java has a front-end middleware and a RabbitMQ Python, which is hosted on Apache. So these are the main three systems we built to address the data integrations in the form of either one of the web services or the batch integrations. So as you can see, we had clients which opted either ETL as well as only one of the service in this. So for example, to integrate the member data, like patient's data into system, as a batch, we had ETL. And to integrate patient's data in a near real-time manner, they opted either one of the services. So because of having these three systems, it was leading us kind of IT burden, where when it comes to deployment, which requires a multiple servers and multiple system deployment onto the client environment. As well as having these multiple systems was leading us to an increased cost in terms of a deployment and getting the servers and the client environment as well. And because of having multiple systems, when it comes to any customization, where client requires for any customization in one single API, or changing the member load or whatever, so it requires we need to ending up doing in multiple places, one for the RESTful web services, either one for a SOAP and one for the ETL. So it was leading us when it comes to deployment, it was not allowing us to do faster releases, so it was leading to impede agility. And because of having multiple systems with a different technology stack, it was leading to a core support and a maintenance in the production support as well. And there are other challenges as the clients are getting into a business requirement changing, where we need to support new healthcare standards like HL7, XTOL, which are not so easy, where we can write a new middleware to integrate with these systems. Those are the main challenges in terms of our data integrators with the HL7 standard and XTOL. And when it comes to a real-time services like RESTful or a SOAP, so when it goes to production, we don't have any monitoring tool where we can check what is the traffic, how many web services are consumed, what is the response time and all these things. So these are the main challenges we faced during our course of Jiva's implementation when it comes to our data integration. Now I would like to call Mr. Harsh to continue the presentation. Thank you.
Hello everyone, good afternoon, and thank you Praveen for your presentation and give us an insight on Jiva platform and the data integration challenges we faced in the past. Of course, so a year ago we started to embark on a project which would meet our data integration challenges by adapting a WSO2 products. We chose WSO2 products because WSO2 products are open source, and provides us a low cost of ownership. It also provides us flexibility to modify the software and innovate on the solution as well. And it's on commercially friendly license, Apache 2.0. Specifically, we have used two products from WSO2 for our initial phase of integration. That's WSO2 Enterprise Service Bus and WSO2 API Manager. We choose WSO2 Enterprise Service Bus because it allows us to connect anything to anything, thus makes our integration seamless to our legacy platform. We have retained our legacy business platform, and most of our integration challenges are addressed through adapting WSO2 middleware products. So as Frank mentioned in the morning, so we had data integration challenge. We had integration patterns to address most of our design problems. And WSO2 ESP do provides us out-of-box mediators to implement those integration patterns. Also, we do a necessary payload transformation, data validation, and protocol switching. The incoming request to the Jiva could be either HTTP or it could be a flat files, whereas the actual data that is going to the business platform is always in the JSON format. So to achieve all this middleware implementation, we have integrated Enterprise Service Bus by adding mediation logic. Also, to serve most of our real-time web services, we have exposed all our APIs to public through API Manager. So API Manager acts as a public interface to all our APIs and do enforce security by authenticating, authorizing, and access controlling all our APIs as well. API Manager do provide with the portals for managing the lifecycle of APIs as well as ease the developers who wants to use our APIs as well. As a whole, we see that WSO2 products do provide us with high performance, high availability, and better configurability. So in the future, we are using a lot of WSO2 products, but as part of our initial phase of migrating to service-oriented architecture, we have created a Jiva API framework. So there was real need for us to expose all our Jiva services as APIs, and also ease Jiva developers who wants to use Jiva APIs as well in their applications. So this is our core Jiva platform where most of our business logic is implemented. So we don't want to rewrite those business logic. Rather, we want to leverage the existing business logic and provide a healthcare solution to external application as well as to our third-party vendors as well. So our core Jiva platform is interfaced through our RabbitMQ. Here, RabbitMQ is a message broker where it enables us to send and receive messages between the external system as well as to our Jiva platform. And this is based on Python. So we have various event queues defined to serve our various business logic as well. So we have various requirements from the client, where some wants to process the data in form of flat files, and some want to do a real-time web services. Again, you know, when we use the flat files, some clients would like to load the data in form of a CSV, and some want to do even XML format as well. And when it comes to real-time web services, we have REST APIs and SOAP proxies. So some clients are so reluctant even to move to the REST because of their business needs. So there is real need for us to even expose our SOAP proxy services as well. So in the past, to achieve all of these, we have created separate or independent deployment models. But there was a lot of challenges where our code was duplicated when it comes to transformation or managing the lifecycle of services. So it was really tough. But integrating Enterprise Service Bus, we are able to have a common mediation layer as well. So we do data validation. So we use out-of-box mediators to achieve our integration patterns. Some of our integration patterns that we use in Enterprise Service Bus is splitter and aggregator, transformation patterns, and also routing patterns as well. We use mediators like XSLT as well as MOOCs to transform the data from CSV to XML, XML to JSON, and again, JSON back to XML, and also necessary other transformations as well. So ideally, the payload that is going out from the Enterprise Service Bus is always a JSON, as a core Jiva platform would process the data in form of JSON. So by integrating middleware, we are able to handle all the necessary transformations and validations at the ESP as well, at the ESP layer. And as part of our real-time web services, we have REST APIs as well as SOAP APIs, and we have integrated API Manager to serve all our APIs as well. And API Manager acts as a gateway to our APIs. And also, we use API Key Manager for enforcing security and also authenticating our requests and also access controlling those requests as well. Today, Zomega has developed a mobile application, and major consumer of our API framework is mobile application, and also our third-party vendors do use our API framework for accessing or for integrating their Jiva services into their platform. API Manager do provides us for various portals to ease the developers as well as publishers. We use API Publisher and API Store. Using API Publisher, we can publishers can publish their APIs and manage the lifecycle of APIs, where APIs can be created, deployed, published, and retired the APIs as well. And also API Store to ease developers, where developers can register their application and start consuming those APIs as well. So as a whole, it really benefited. And in the future, say we want to incorporate HL7 transaction, and for that is specific to more of healthcare standards. And ESB do provide such flexibility even to support HL7. And also, we want to support some of the other formats like X12 as well as Fire. ESB do provide us those connectors to achieve those implementations. And here's our Jiva next generation SOA model. And today, most of our Jiva applications and Jiva services is tightly bound. The switches are tightly bound to applications. So we want to move away from a monolithic kind of applications to more of reusable component services. And that is where we want to use WSO2 products to achieve this. Some of the Jiva reusable components that we are planning to integrate in the future are identity server to provide authentication as well as access control, and also some of the reusable components in the future that we use are analytics that can be distributed across the Jiva platform. And here's a future of integration. We want to leverage Enterprise Service Bus as well as API Manager to support future health-specific standards like HL7 and X12. And also, we want to use new HTTP resource methods, those standards that's been provided by ITF. So today, we use GET, PUT, POST, HTTP resource methods for accessing our various, performing our various API operations. And we want to use a patch method that's provided to just update only the part of the data. And also, we want to use monitoring as well as monetization for APIs as well. And WSO2 identity server. So as part of our Jiva next generation SOA model, we want to provide a common truth of identity for all the Jiva services as well as the Jiva modules as well. So we want to use OpenID Connect for user authentication, and just-in-time provisioning, federation authentication, and integrating with third-party user stores like Active Directory, LDAP, as well as the third-party user stores. And in future, not just about these three products, we also want to provide SOA governance and flexibility for our DevOps. We want to use governance registry and data services for our database integration layer as well. So as a whole, we are able to achieve a robust solution by integrating WS2 products. And we are now moving away from a kind of spending more of our efforts on business infrastructure. Rather, now we are able to speed up our agility by creating a healthcare solutions.